today, there's a little over 200 megawatts of floating offshore wind commissioned in the first 16 years of the industry. Under construction are projects that will quadruple the amount installed, and over 200 gigawatts of potential projects have been announced. Europe has been the hub for floating offshore wind, with Norway leading the charge. France has several smaller projects under construction, and the UK leads with ambitious plans for 13 gigawatts of floating wind. Japan, with its extensive coastline and vast exclusive economic zone, EEZ, sees offshore wind as vital for its energy transition. South Korea is another country with several projects of around 1 gigawatt currently in planning, and the first to begin construction is expected to be the 504 megawatt stage 1 of Grey Whale 3 wind farm in late 24. China is also entering the floating wind arena, aiming to drive down costs and accelerate global adoption, similar to what they've already done for solar panels and lithium-ion batteries. The US is moving ahead with floating wind efforts, and even here in Australia, we're forging ahead with floating wind projects being planned in a couple of regions that don't suit fixed bottom.